सत्संग, टुडे सत्संग इन भगवत गीता फिफ्थ चैप्टर संन्यास योगा 27th and 28th वर्सेस।
स्पर्शान कृत्वा बहिर्बाह्यां चक्षुश्चैवांतरे भ्रुवो प्राणापानौ समौ कृत्वा नासाभ्यंतरकारिणौ यतेन्द्रिय मनो बुद्धिर् मुनिर्मोक्ष परायणः विगते च भयक्रोधो यस्सदा मुक्तये वसः।
ब्यूटिफुल बोथ द वर्सेस। स्पर्शान कृत्वा बहिर्बाह्यांश्च चक्षुश्चैवान्तरब्रुवो प्राणापानौ समौ कृत्वा नासाभ्यन्तरचारिणौ यदेन्द्रिय मनोबुद्धिर्मुनिर्मोक्ष परायणः विगदेश्च भयक्रोतो यः सता मुक्त एव सः। बोथ वर्सेस टुगेदर यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड। लेट मी गिव यू द ट्रांसलेशन। द वन who has made the sense objects remain outside by retaining the sight between the eyebrows, being in deep meditation, by balancing the life breath that moves inward and outward through the nostrils, by subduing the senses, the thoughts and the intelligence, having removed desire, fear and anger, being intent upon loosening the bonds, remains always relaxed and free. Understand these few sacred secrets. First, Bhagavan starts with the lifestyle. The first line he says is, the one who has made the sense objects remain outside by retaining the sight between the eyebrows. The first part, one who has made the sense objects remain outside, this teaches you enlightened lifestyle. The second statement, retaining the sight between the eyebrows, this is the technique. Please understand, enlightened lifestyle prepares you for the extraordinary experiences. Techniques gives you extraordinary experiences. Enlightenment, realization, samyama gives you extraordinary powers. See the three classification clearly. Enlightened lifestyle is more life solution that prepares the ground, root. Then comes technique, which gives you extraordinary experiences. Then comes realization, anubhava or anubhuti, which gives extraordinary powers. If you see Jnanasambandha's life, Jnanasambandha is one of the great incarnation. He is considered to be the incarnation of Subramanya, Skanda, because Jnanasambandha had Parvati, Parvati's milk, breast milk, the enlightening milk, is considered as the incarnation of Subramanya in the Saiva Siddhanta tradition. One of the great saint. If you see his life, the experience of Devi appearing and giving enlightening milk to him leads to the samyama, realization, an expression of extraordinary powers. In his life, the life solutions did not pay much role, play much role, because from the very young age, he had the extraordinary experiences and powers. If you understand these three classifications, many of your confusions related to spirituality will disappear. Many times, people try to think one is enough or one is higher than the other. Please understand, if you are matured, even one is not necessary. In these three, nothing is necessary. Ashtavakra, the moment he is born, he neither had experience nor had any powers, lived enlightenment. Sri Ramakrishna had all the three. Life solutions means enlightened lifestyle, and then the extraordinary experiences, and samyama, the power, realization. In Jnana Sambandha's life, if you see, you will see two things. As a three-year-old child, he did not study any shastras. He did not started going to school. He did not learn the lifestyle of enlightenment. He did not practice anything. Straight Devi appeared and gave the enlightening milk. And that experience has led to the samyama realization. And he started expressing extraordinary powers. Neither one is higher than the other, nor one is lower than the other. For ordinary people, all the three are required. Don't try to have just one, not the other. If you have only technique, you may have extraordinary powers, but you may not have enlightened lifestyle, the lifestyle of compassion, love, the nervous system to radiate the joy. You may be missing that. I have seen many street magicians in India. They have real powers. Please understand, they are not just doing some magic. They have miraculous powers. I myself have seen that the street, some of the tribes who are followers of one or two of the techniques, they will follow just one or two techniques and have one or two powers. I have seen them converting ash into kumkum, just an ordinary rope into snake. It is not magic, it's a real power. They play with the miraculous powers. But they miss an important dimension of life, the enlightened lifestyle. Because of that, these powers are not useful to their life. It is not useful to others' life. Yesterday somebody asked me, Swamiji, I have studied many of the spiritual philosophies, organizations, followers. I have read many spiritual literatures, modern day spiritual organization. One thing I can distinctly see the difference with your teachings and your organization. Your teachings, either your teachings or your disciples, so intense in everything. How is this, Swamiji? How do you manage it? That is why I have to suffer so much. Really? See the amount of intensity. I don't cut brinjals. I cut diamonds. Understand, when you cut brinjal, the stress and strain is lot less. The pressure you need to apply is lot less. The work you need to do is lot less. But when you cut diamond, the stress and strain is too much. Even if you pour millions of liters of coolants, coolants become steam in the heat produced. My love is the coolant, but how much ever I produce, I pour the coolants. The very heat I create makes all the coolant into steam. If you know the diamond cutting process, you will understand what I am saying. Coolant is usually used to reduce the stress and strain during the cutting process, the grinding process. In Manasarovar, this time, usually I drop something in Manasarovar. It's a tradition when you go to Manasarovar or Varanasi, you drop some of your important patterns there and come back. What pattern I have nothing. Last time somehow I find something to drop. I have decided to drop. Whoever comes to me for any boon, I will not judge. Any power expresses through this body, blesses that, attests, over. Only yes. No, no. I dropped the no and I am leaving. This time what will I drop? I tried my best. Finally, I found one thing. I don't have anger itself in my heart, but sometime to train the disciples, I show that Rudra Rupa. I've decided I'll drop that. So, you guys will not, I don't know, especially people who live around me or lived around me can't believe. Almost last 20 days, I am not screaming at anybody. I have not raised my voice. I have not shown my big, big eyes. I also told my disciples that we will do a brain study on me, that even that grew, anger grew, and the red cells, which is responsible for anger, has disappeared from my brain. The moment I said I am dropping, dropped, over. The whole physiology has changed. Whole biomemory is different. Of course, I never had anger inside. It was only a show, a mask with which I used to play. So that people feel, people understand that what they are doing is wrong. Sometime when they do wrong. Now, that's also over. They asked me, why did you drop this, Swamiji? Many people, they had the crocodile tears. No, 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 no. You cannot drop this. I said, decision is not in your hand. I already decided. This is the way it is going to be. Through this, I am increasing the coolant. That's all, nothing else. Through this, the coolant has increased. The intensity which my teachings and you guys radiate is because all these three is given equivalent importance in our Sangha. The enlightened lifestyle, constantly I am doing through morning satsang. And the technique, I don't know how many thousands of meditation, kriya, yogic techniques I have shared. Techniques. Next, a very important thing, realization. Kundalini awakening comes under that classification. Please understand. Just by the look, touch, word, so much of energy transmission, energy radiation, kundalini awakening, experiences, samyama is happening. So much of intense spiritual transformation for so many people is possible because all these three are happening simultaneously. Simultaneously, all these three, enlightened lifestyle through the teachings, techniques, and experience. Here, Bhagavan is sharing these three in this one verse. The one who has made the sense objects remain outside by retaining the sight between the eyebrows. First line is enlightened lifestyle, means made the sense objects remain outside. Second line, retaining the sight between the eyebrows. It's a technique. Third, by balancing the life breath that moves inward and outward through the nostrils. This again a technique. By subduing the senses. This is an enlightened lifestyle. The thoughts and the intelligence. This again enlightened lifestyle. Having removed desire, fear and anger. Enlightened lifestyle. Being intent upon losing the bonds. Remains always relaxed and free. The last line is experience, samyama. Pick up all the three in your life, that is the complete spiritual life. The one who has made the sense objects remain outside by retaining the sight between the eyebrows, being in deep meditation, by balancing the life breath that moves inward and outward through the nostrils, by subduing the senses, the thoughts and the intelligence, having removed desire, fear and anger, being intent upon losing the bonds, remains always relaxed and free. Bhagavan is giving the technique. We'll try this technique from today. See, keep all the sense objects outside. Means decide all your sense organs, you are shutting it. Consciously close it. Put a shutter. Tuck, 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 tuck. And then bring your awareness to your center of the eyebrow, the Ajna. Feel very clearly the prana going in and prana coming out. Both are balanced. It means the moment you bring your awareness, it will automatically balance itself. You don't try to control. Just bring awareness. See, it's like a kids. You don't need to control. Just if you bring awareness on them, they'll settle down. You don't need to control. Just bring the awareness that you are watching. There is an eye on the child. It'll simply settle down. Bring your awareness on the prana. Going in and coming out. Internally, do not allow the boilings to happen. Desire, fear, anger, those boilings weaken your nervous system. I tell you, if you allow the boiling of fear, desire and anger, you will have the worst old age. You will be in hell. You will not be able to control your nervous system. That leads to suffocation. So many other disorders. So let me give the step-by-step instruction for the technique. Sit and visualize all your senses are shut. I'll guide you. Please get ready. Sit straight. Close your eyes. Visualize. All your senses are shut. I am telling you guys to close the sense door, and Singapore they are closing the center door. close the door of the senses. That is more important. And bring your awareness to the eyebrow. Tanya chakra. Do not control, but bring awareness to inhaling and exhaling prana. Prana which goes inside and outside. And do not allow the desire, fear, anger inside you. Subdue the senses, the thoughts, and the intelligence. Do not allow the anger, fear to work. Keep the senses shut. Bring your awareness to the center of your third eye, between the eyebrows. relax. I bless you all.
Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind Body Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages, in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam. Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papa vinashaktam, nityanandaya swagatam. Shantamayam bandham, Nityanandaya swagatam.